Good afternoon, everyone. This is 287. Today I'm going to do a short video, once again in reference to another question I was asked. And this question was asked about the Shroud of Turin. Now, for those who don't know, to be brief, the Shroud of Turin is about this linen cloth that was found and it has an image on it. So they've extrapolated through all these scientific processes. And some people believe it is the image of the Savior himself. While there have been many theories, there's also been a carbon dating testing on it that says it's a medieval fake dated somewhere around the 13th century. So bottom line, with this linen cloth that has this image on it, allegedly, it looks like an image of a man who was crucified. Bottom line is that it's surrounded by tons of theories and hypotheses and all these things. And really, what it's serving as is a distraction, as far as I'm concerned. But anyway, the question that was asked in reference to that, if I thought that was the image of Yeshua, or as most people say, Jesus, which is the Roman Greek name that was given, I'm going to respond to it this way. We're going to start with the Heavenly Father himself. So let's get going with, have you seen the Father? Now, this is an interesting topic because there have always been claims throughout history of individuals saying that they have seen the Father or that they have seen the Son. So we're going to go through a little bit of what Scripture tells us is and isn't. We're going to start with John 6:45. And it reads, "It is written in the prophets, and they shall be all taught of God. Every man therefore that hath heard and hath learned of the Father cometh unto me. Not that any man hath seen the Father, save he which is of God, he hath seen the Father." So the Savior himself is telling us that only he who is of the Father has seen him. And we know that he is speaking of himself, because none of us are of the Father. But we'll prove some of that with Scripture as we go along here. Now, in Exodus 33:20, we find out something about the Father himself, because it is not possible for any of us to see the Father and survive because of that glory. Now, we're going to go to Exodus 33 and start with verse 17. Now, this is at the point where Moses is on the Mount Sinai with the Heavenly Father. And Moses wants to see the Father. So, listen to what happened here. We're going to start with verse 17. It reads, "And the Lord said unto Moses, I will do this thing also that thou hast spoken, for thou hast found grace in my sight, and I know thee by name." Verse 18, "And he said, I beseech thee, show me thy glory." Verse 19, "And he said, I will make all my goodness pass before thee, and I will proclaim the name of the Lord before thee, and will be gracious to whom I will be gracious, and will show mercy on whom I will show mercy." Verse 20, "And he said, thou cannot see my face, for there shall no man see me and live. And the Lord said, behold, there is a place by name, and thou shalt stand upon a rock. And it came to pass," verse 22, "and it came to pass, while my glory passeth by, that I will put thee in a cliff of the rock, and will cover thee with my hand while I pass. And I will take away mine hand, and thou shalt see my back parts, but my face shall not be seen." Now, there are many other scriptures that confirm that no man can see him and survive. His glory, that glory is too bright. he allowed Moses to see him as he passed by, but he covered his face. So Moses saw him as going by him, that glory. Remember when he came off the mountain, he had this glow about him because the glory of the Father was on him. That's how bright it was. That's how much it changed him. Now, there was also a man named Manoah and his wife, and they were the parents of Samson. So we're going to go to Judges 13, 21 and 22 and see what that says. Now, Judges 13 and 21 reads, "But the angel of the Lord did not more appear to Manoah and to his wife. Then Manoah knew that he was an angel of the Lord. And Manoah said unto his wife, We shall surely die because we have seen God." Manoah figured out that he and his wife had been speaking to an angel of the Heavenly Father. And for an individual to even be in the presence of an angel, for them, that was being in the presence of God. If you knew you were in the presence of a holy angel, you would proclaim that you were in the presence of God, because they are from heaven. They are angelic beings, and they have a glory about them. There's always going to be a claim that individuals make that they have seen God. But if we understand that His glory is too much for a man to take, you understand that we could never truly see God in this form that we are. So, has any man seen the Father and survived? No, not according to Scripture. So, what about the Savior Himself? Well, the disciples and plenty of others saw their Savior, but in terms of things like the Shroud of Turin and all these foolish images that I will show you momentarily to end my video, all these types of claims that they are of the Savior, Yeshua Himself, I believe it not to be true. Remember, the Heavenly Father, our loving Heavenly Father, is not a prankster. He would not do simple, foolish things as this to reveal Himself to us. He is revealed fully in His Word. We do not have to see the Father to proclaim Him or to know Him. All this foolishness is the work of the enemy. Remember, he's the one who likes distraction. He's the one who likes to deceive us. People will spend their whole lives focusing on images in trees, on the corner of bathtubs, reflections in mirrors, or what have you, and claim that it is the Savior and focus on that more so than they will focus on the Word. The enemy will distract you until it is too late for you, and you will claim that you are somewhere that you need to be. You went in the other direction. So with that, I'm going to end this study with John 1:18. John 1:18 reads, "No man hath seen God at any time. The only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, He hath declared Him." So He is the only one that can declare that He has seen the Father, because He is of the Father. And with that being said, remember, keep in mind, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 2:7.